Okay, this is Louis. Oh, did they make a guess on his age, Bev? Because we weren't sure. I think they said maybe eight. They said eight. Okay, good guess. He came to us from Evansville Animal Control. And you're going to have to bear with me a little bit here because usually I have my notes in text form, but all of his information came on a shelter form that the owners filled out. They said he's 8 years old. They couldn't afford him anymore. She said she was raising her four grandkids. So, you know, hard times. A dollar can only go so far sometimes. Said she'd had him for 2 years. He was in the house when she moved into it. I'm renting. The owner moved away and left him in there. He was getting vet care. And no illnesses, no symptoms, no requiring veterinary care. He just got regular care. Said he likes to play with rope toys. He was kept primarily outdoors, only occasionally indoors. And you can see his elbows there and his back feet, the discoloration. Sometimes you see that when they've been kept outside.
His coat is dense.
Okay, if you couldn't hear that, she said his coat is really, really dense. Another sign that they've been living outside. It is a beautiful coat, too. It's very nice indeed. Just watch him while I look at my notes here. Does he chase things? Rabbits? Well, sure. They describe, there are numerous adjectives here, including aggressive, protective, unsure. They checked playful. He has killed a rabbit, but they said he lived with cats in the house. Said he was fine, stayed away from them. I don't know if our adoptions coordinator noticed that, and I really need to note that he's cat friendly. With visiting pets, he played in the backyard with them. With other pets on walks or in public, he ignores them. He has lived with children. Oh, she said she had the four grandchildren, ages 5, 7, 9, and 11. Absolutely loves kids. Always positive experiences with children. Let's see. Oh, said he doesn't like to be yanked on the collar, which that's very common, and he yelps if you do that. She did indicate that he growled at a dog one time who was taking his food. So that was just a growl and not an all-out fight. And you're a good-sized boy. You could have put a whooping on him if you'd wanted to. They have a checklist here. Again, I'm sorry, this is not my normal format. They list all kinds of things like growled when a person tries to touch food, growls when you try and touch toys, growls or bites when you try to touch treats. Let's see. And anyway, they checked. He's not bothered by any of that. Said he loves being brushed and bathed. Asked about having the nails trimmed, and they did not know. They said he loves riding in a car. Now, I'm going to point out here, I don't know how often he'd been in a car. Maybe he was upset because he was put in a car and dumped. But Bev here took him to the vet, said he was extremely anxious and somewhat destructive in the car. He was really upset by being in the car. So it's important you know that if you want to adopt him, if you come to meet him and think you might take him home, you need to bring a crate in your car. And you may need to travel with a crate who knows how long, unless, you know, you can work on desensitizing him to that. But for now, he needs to travel in a crate and does not enjoy travel. You know, some dogs will give him a little Benadryl before traveling to kind of make him a little dozy. They did offer to give him something at the vet, but Bev didn't want to put him completely out. So, okay, we've made that point. You're aware of it. That's about the only thing we have to say that might be something you'd have to work with a little bit. He was not eating the best food. He's getting great food here. Said he likes milk bones. Did he? He did clean up those ones on the floor, didn't he? Yeah, he's not an underweight dog.
No, he's not.
But he's just a good weight, I think, for a mature dog.
He might be a little heavy. good.
Just a little bit, though, because you know how I am about that. Let's see. What are some things you truly love about this dog? He talks to me.
He's a big talker.
Is he a talker? Because I haven't heard anything. Maybe he talks when he's in the car. Oh, look, he keeps offering that paw, doesn't he? They didn't list if he knew any commands. Did you try?
I tried
all of them.
Me, but he sure just waved that buck. Didn't he?
Yeah. Well, and he is parked back there too, getting his leans and his leg hugs, huh?
Yeah, he's a fortunate.
Beautiful, nice, nice boy. And you know that 8's a good age because I mean they really have that puppy silliness out of the way. But you can have it long through many years, and he has a good, solid health history. So they never come with guarantees, but he's a good age for an old lady like me, huh? Yes, yes, he is. Very handsome. Look at those beautiful eyes. Hi. Let's see if he likes the ball, because we didn't mention that. You want a ball? What have I got? Just kind of what is it? Not that interesting, huh? Do you like squeakies? Does that remind you of rabbits? Good boy. He looks like he might like some plushy squeaky toys at your house. We don't leave them with those here, of course, because we don't want them to eat them. But he is just a great, great little husky for probably somebody that doesn't travel a whole lot. You know, so the car thing is minimized. Probably not an RV traveling dog. But other than that, he's pretty much awesome. Don't let me forget to, I want to do pictures. We'll have to walk him by the cats. Come here. Give us a kiss. Here we go. Hello, screenshot. Oh my goodness, those kittens are crazy.
Oh, they're kittens.
Well, yeah.
I like that.
How about these big fat cats? Bob and Crew. I don't know.
I think the kitties scared me.
Yeah, I think they did too. That doesn't mean that would last. Well, if you have cats, check back and we'll try and do a better test. These kittens are nut bars.